I have Spanish slugs, another small species as well. Can I attract and encourage more slug predators? I'm sure you can. My chickens only eat one or two small ones if I encourage them and seem to ignore them otherwise. My small suburban garden does not seem to be attracting the help I need. There are native toads I've seen some 100 meters away. Will they wander that far to my site? Would it be bad to bring a few there myself? Well, you could import some toads or some frogs. I've done that in suburban gardens. You want to put up a small pond. Get a pond with shallow sloping edges. That's what the frogs and toads like. That's predator habitat. And you'll also bring in dragonflies and other kinds of unusual predators. You need rock piles as well. So a few rockeries bring in lizards, because lizards work during the day when it's hot and dry. And frogs and toads, they work at night and when it's cloudy and rainy like this. But also, much better than chickens for slug predators are ducks. These are Muscovies, which are kind of genetically like geese, but any duck is a great slug predator. And you can get small call ducks, very small, cute little ducks that are actually used for decoys, live decoys traditionally, but they're very small and they'll fit into an urban garden. Or you can get miniatures, so half breeds. So it is possible to use ducks. Now, you're also in the cooler, humid climates, you'll often get slug problems. So there's a lot of things people have designed for preventing slug problems so much. Copper tape is a copper foil tape. It's a sticky tape. You put around rings of plumbing pipe to put around your seedlings. Particularly seedlings can get decimated by slugs. Sawdust. Slugs won't cross sawdust. Slugs also won't cross shredded bamboo mulch. It's a bit sharp for them. You'll also get rose hip thorns. They're so covered in thorns in all directions. A little ring of those and they won't cross. Beer traps are another thing. There are even tiny little slug electric fences that run on batteries that people put around their gardens. So if you look at the permaculture websites of the cooler, humid climates, you'll see a lot of slug prevention methods. And when you get systems at work, spread the news to other people.